Hello my dear students, welcome again. Today we will start with the same lesson, topic number 4, that is warfare for wealth. In lecture number 1, we have studied about the emergence of the new dynasties, that is Rashtrakuta dynasty, Gurjara Pratihara dynasty, Chola dynasty and Pala dynasty. These ruling dynasties have some specific region to rule, but these dynasties try to expand their region by gaining the power over the other areas. Now, why these dynasties try to expand their region? First one, to increase their power. Second one, to gain the wealth, to acquire the wealth. And the third one, to capture the resources. For example, Gurjara Pratihara dynasty overthrew the Rashtrakuta and expanded their territory. At the same time, they increased their power by expanding the region, and they also gained the wealth because Rashtrakuta dynasty was very rich in resources. Why the ruling dynasties have struggled among them? So this is the reason why we have warfare for the wealth. In our textbook, they have given the 3 examples which have the warfare for the wealth. Among them, the first one is the tri-party struggle. Note, second one, attack of Muhammad Ghazni, and the third one is Prithviraj III versus Muhammad Ghori. Now let us see the first one, that is tri-party struggle for Kannauj. Now Kannauj was the city of Madhya Pradesh in the Ganga Valley, and Kannauj was very rich in agriculture because the land of the Kannauj was very fertile. Now the ruling dynasty, now the 3 ruling dynasties we have studied about, the Rashtrakuta dynasty, Gurjara Pratihara dynasty and Chola dynasty. Kannauj was the city in Uttar Pradesh in the Ganga Valley. The land of the Kannauj was very fertile and rich in agriculture resources. So these 3 ruling dynasties, that is Gurjara Pratihara dynasty, Rashtrakuta dynasty and Pala dynasty, were fighting among themselves to gain the control over the Kannauj. And so the historians call this struggle as the tri-party struggle. Now, during this period, rulers demonstrate their power and wealth by building the temples. So the ruling dynasties targeted the temples while attacking on one another, which would make them extremely rich. Second one is the attack of Muhammad Ghazni. During medieval period, many foreign invaders attacked the different parts of subcontinent. One of the most famous ruler was Muhammad Sultan Ghazni, who was from Afghanistan. Mostly he tried to extend his control over the northwestern part of the subcontinent. He ruled from 997 to 1030. That is, he ruled nearly 27 years, and out of 27 years, he raided 17 times to our subcontinent. He mostly extended his power, he mostly extended his power to the Central Asia and the northwestern part of India, Iran, etc. He raided to the Somnath temple of Gujarat. Now, whatever wealth he used to gain, he used to take to his country and develop his capital city at Ghazni by constructing the road, buildings, etc. So, when Muhammad Ghazni became rich by extending his power mostly to the different parts of the Indian subcontinent, and mostly he targeted the temples for wealth. Muhammad Ghazni entrusted a scholar named Al-Burani to write his account of his victory, how he conquered the different parts of the subcontinent and so on. This Arabic work was known as Kitab ul Hind. And because of this written account only, we came to know about Muhammad Ghazni's victories. So this was the second warfare for wealth, that is the attack of Muhammad Ghazni. The third one was between Prithviraj III versus Muhammad Ghori. The other kings who were engaged in the warfare include the Chamanas, later on which were known as the Chauhans, who ruled over the who ruled over the regions of Delhi and Ajmer. They tried to extend their power to the northwestern part and the east, but they were opposed by the Chalukyas of Gujarat and the Gadwals of the Uttar Pradesh. These kings belong to the Rajput dynasty. The well-known Chauhan ruler Prithviraj III ruled from 1168 to 1192. He defeated Muhammad Ghori in 1991 but let him free. The Rajput ruler showed that courtesy by leaving him, but Muhammad Ghori immediately the next year Ghori attacked, and in this war Prithviraj III was defeated. This way there was the battle between Prithviraj III versus Muhammad Ghori. So these are the three examples given for the warfare for the wealth. So children, I hope you have understood what were the reasons for the warfare for the wealth. So for today, this much is enough. Read concept from your textbook clearly. Thank you.